Hello, everyone. Hello, Michael.
Hello, hello.
How are you doing today?
Doing really well. I'm excited that it is Friday, and
yes,
August Friday, which means lots of big things happening in the world in terms of people going back to school and us starting a new thing.
I'm
pretty excited about it.
I know. So experience Friday Live. Michael, you and I've talked about doing this for a long time. And so we are really excited to have this come to life. And I know, Michael, people have asked us, so what is Experience Friday Live? We've had lots of questions around that. And, I think, Michael, you wrote this, and I think this is really awesome, that experiences matter. Whether you're interacting with customers, engaging your workforce, or growing your businesses, the experiences that you and your company create hold the power to make or break you. And so that you and I wanted to start a show to help those navigate and humanize this complex world of experiences. And the experience ecosystem, which we're going to talk about here in a little bit, and connect with experts. I know this show, it's just you and I that get us today. Because we wanted to introduce it, and also we wanted to make sure if we made any mistakes that it was only with us on here.
That's correct.
So I do think we do have some exciting announcements, though. Michael, I'll share a little bit about season 5 of the Combustion Chronicles, and then let's jump into today. So next week, go ahead, Michael.
Well, I was going to say, even with all of this, thus kicking off this emphasis on experience, you know, the world doesn't need another LinkedIn Live show. You know, the world doesn't need another podcast. There is gazillions of podcasts out there that everybody has a podcast. And so for me, starting all this with this emphasis, that experiences do matter. And that it matters on so many different levels. So it matters because it is something that affects your business in terms of revenue and profitability. And it also affects your business because it affects people. And, you know, in the end, all of us are in business, not necessarily just to get super, 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 super rich, right? That somewhere there's a mission in there, and that mission matters. And so experiences matter, and making the mission matter. And I think for both of us, the bottom line for this is that you can have a business that makes a lot of money, that you make really wise business decisions, and you can still change people's lives for the better and make their lives easier and help them in some way. And that's why you have a business. And so to blend all that together, I'm excited about it. I'm excited to be able to bring in people that are going to have good conversations about it.
So I'm going to ask you this then, Michael, because I mean, I can answer this, but I want you to. So who is Experience Friday Live designed for? Because this is our first one, and people are going to watch this. It's live on Facebook today. It's live on LinkedIn. It's live on Twitter. So people are going to watch this afterwards. It's going to be on our YouTube channel. Who is this designed for? And even more importantly, you know, we don't want to be the only two on this screen every week. We want guests here. Michael, who are the guests that we want on here that they could reach out to us and speak to us?
Yeah, so the primary audience for us, I believe, is people who are in the experience world somehow, right? So people who are we'll talk about ecosystems a little bit, but have some kind of connection to an experience ecosystem whose daily work somehow involves designing, executing, training people in experiences. And that's who we hope to bring on and talk about things so we can connect people and what they're doing in various parts of their ecosystems. I'm going to say and not but here. And I hope we find an audience and people that don't know much about experience and are interested in it, or people who have never thought that experience is a part of their job, but it really is. So I hope we get those folks too, that maybe they're on the fringe of an experience ecosystem or don't quite understand what their role is in the experience world. And that's a lot of people, because who in the world does not touch experience somewhere? We have a social media post going out soon about who's on your experience team. And it's really easy to say, that person's in charge of customer experience, or this person's in charge of employee experience. That's our experience team. And the answer is no. Everybody raise your hand in the entire company. Everybody's in charge of sales. Not in charge. Everyone is on the sales team. Everybody. And also everybody's on the experience team.
Yep. Right. So, Michael, we put up there, that if you play in the experience system, we want you. They can send us an email at info@mofi.co. And we're scheduling to get people on here, because our plan is, even if both of us aren't here, every Friday for us to do this show. So send us an email at info@mofi.co. That is .co, not .com. And we would love to have you on the show. Additionally, Michael, what are we wanting to accomplish? I know for me, I'll share a minute, or that I want to meet really kick-ass people who are challenging. We've talked about this a lot, Michael, about challenging the status quo, right? I want to meet people that are challenging the status quo in the experience ecosystem. And purposely, I've put a lot of things behind my desk here. You can see all kinds of things about who we are and who I am. That's what excites me. And I want to meet really great people that are willing to go along this journey in this experience ecosystem with us and hear their stories. And I think most importantly, and Michael, you and I live this day to day, is that we want authentic, transparent people who are going to share the good, bad, the ugly of working in experience, because we all need to hear it, because it's, let's be real, it's not all good here. What do you want to accomplish by doing this show, Michael?
I want to connect people that have some kind of passion, and I love the challenging the status quo angle, so that we're getting people who are thinking differently, who aren't willing to put up with just the way it's always been. So, in whatever size company, we talk about experience silos a lot. And the more we talk with people, the more we hear about their experience silos, that, the people that are training the frontline workers for customer service are doing it differently than the people that are training people over here to do customer service. And that's still different than the people that are training that are onboarding all employees to even talk about customer experience. And so to bring all those things together to both rethink the status quo and then talk about real ideas that can do big things and are thinking innovatively and thinking in things that have not been done before and aren't afraid to take some risks and to try some new things. And it's much, if we all take some risks in different places and then we collect that data, everybody wins. And so that's what I'm looking forward to the most, is getting into people's stories that are actually doing this day to day.
Yeah, me too. And Michael, I think part of that, and we're going to jump into what we consider the experience ecosystem to set some ground. But one of the big things that we did is we took our podcast, The Combustion Chronicles, and we're kicking it off next.
I say not to brag, but I think we do need to. It's been rated one of the top 3% in the world of all podcasts based on downloads.
Yeah. So yeah, and
that's a lot.
The funny thing about that, right, Michael, is that we started by me being bored during the pandemic and calling you, going, "Let's start a podcast," right?
Right.
But it's been powerful. And so it's the Combustion Chronicles. If you've not listened to it, the exciting thing is the rest of the year, starting next Wednesday, we are kicking off our season 5. Wednesday, August 11th. And if you have not heard of Colin Shaw, and Michael's probably grabbing his book if he's got it there with him. I forgot to grab mine. The Experience Economy with Colin Shaw, Memories, Fishing Nets, and the Importance of Behavioral Science. That drops next Wednesday, the kickoff to season 5. Be watching, because we'll be promoting all the guests. We have some amazing guests next season that are working in this space. So really excited about that. Again, the Combustion Chronicles, you can download it on any platform out there. It's even on Pandora. If you like Pandora, it's on the Pandora platform, but all available. And if you missed it, Michael and I, with our co-author, Robin Glasgow, just did a mini-series called Kiss Your Dragons. And you see the book right behind me here. Go download it. You can start listening to that this week as well. So,
Michael, do you want to go over any of the big names?
I think we kick off. I think maybe we'll do a teaser video for the group next week, and we'll drop it down. I think Colin's big enough. If you've not heard of Colin Shaw, you guys, just an amazing. I was introduced to his work a long, long time ago. And he's done some powerful things, and he's one of the biggest leading influencers on LinkedIn today, with something like 300,000 plus. It's crazy. Again, that'll be coming out next week. So, Michael, let's talk about the experience ecosystem, and what that means and what that looks like. I wanna pull up a little background here. And just if you want to talk to it for a second, Michael, and then we can we'll come back on live. But tell us a little bit about the experience ecosystem.
So the more we've talked to people, and we've talked to a lot of people, it is amazing how many people talk about their silos. And we call them experience silos. And what that means is that people are doing experience. They're doing employee experience, they're doing digital experience, they're doing UX on their website, they're doing customer service, and they're all really proud of themselves for doing customer experience, but they're not doing it in a unified way that can have the impact that is possible if you rethink that as an ecosystem. And so that's where the ecosystem comes from. And the definition we have that you were showing there is looking at holistically what can happen. It's the people, the touch points, the interactions, and they come together around an experience process. And that can lead you to create a holistic understanding of experience that will give you a competitive advantage. And that's when you build the customer loyalty. That's when you see your revenues go up. And that to me is what so many companies are missing right now and so many people are wanting. And looking at a stat earlier that 58% of people, according to one study, report that in their company, that their company puts profits over people. And we can tear down these experience silos and align the company around people. And so we're talking about humanizing this experience ecosystem. And when we humanize the experience ecosystem, that's when you're going to see your metrics go up, whatever your key KPIs are. You're going to see your revenues go up, or at least your income go up. It's up to you how you spend it, right? Yeah. But that's when you're going to see that success. And so the big part of that experience ecosystem for us is that you've got to align that ecosystem around an experience promise. And the experience promise is what unifies people to be able to understand what you want people in the experience ecosystem to experience on that emotional level and how you bring that to life. So if you look at this ecosystem in this graphic, we've got customer experience at the top, but customer experience can only exist well when you're also working with the employee experience and you're working with supply chain, things that people don't think about, like vendor experience, that's all tied together with your leadership and culture. And then you got to think about things like brand loyalty and messaging, and you've got to think about the marketplace awareness, which means that they're not, your customers are, and your employees are not comparing your product or service against another product or experience anymore. What they're looking at is the last experience that they had with anyone. So even if you are working with someone with employee experience, in the back of their head, they're thinking about what Amazon does to make their lives easier. And so they're comparing their employee experience against the last experience they had with Amazon, or that they had with, at the doctor's office, or that they had, whatever great experience they had, that's what they're comparing themselves against. And so the only way for this ecosystem to really function well is this experience promise.
Yep. And Michael, we've been really fortunate. And again, we talk about this a lot. You know, I have this mouse behind me that I used to work for. And you see my hard hat over on this side as a Walt Disney Imagineer. Disney does this brilliantly, and they really brought this to market for tons of people and organizations. And we have just taken it and massaged it and added our take to it here at Mophi. We've seen this really be successful in some big organizations around the whole experience being looked at. And what would be your one point of advice on how to just dive into the experience ecosystem? I'm hoping that we're going to have one of our partners that we just started with this on in Denver to share her journey with us. But what would you say, in your opinion, would be the first step that you needed to take?
Awareness. It's always about awareness for me. And so you can both chart your current state and your future state that you want to get to. So the first step of, solving a problem is owning the problem, right? So if you start with charting where you currently are and where experience happens in an organization, and you get the right people in the room, right? So that you're able to see all the different voices of the people paying attention that they truly are in charge of experience now, you'll be surprised. How many people have some kind of influence in the experience world if you look at it more broadly. And once you have that, then you can start looking at, okay, then what does that experience process look like across the ecosystem? But starting place for me is just awareness. So get people together and start charting both where you are and where you want to go.
Well, awesome, Michael. Again, really excited about what we're doing here on Experience Friday Live to talk about the experience ecosystem. One of the things you and I kind of talked about, Michael, was just to share like what's happening in the world, right? And what we see happening. And so one of the things that I find really intriguing that's happening as a spark and a stoke for us to look at is this whole concept, and I'm pulling it up because I really think it's really important for us to see, that McDonald's appoints its first global chief customer officer. And there's a lot of opinions around McDonald's. And what it said here is that we have reached a pivotal moment when technology and data have begun to shape nearly every facet of the customer experience. What is your thought? Like McDonald's now hiring a chief customer officer, and this is in the Wall Street Journal, so this is pretty powerful. Well, what's your take on it?
Yeah, three things. One, I think there's this trend of what is it, 10, 15 years ago, everyone appointed their first chief innovation officer, and that became a thing on LinkedIn, yep. right? And no one really knew what that was. And more importantly, no one knew what to do with that officer. Were they in marketing? Were they in sales? Were they, who do they report up to? And there's been all, and you're the organizational the org chart person there, Shawn. So would love to unpack a little bit of that, of how that works or doesn't work. My second response is, okay, so they appoint this customer officer. Where does that person sit in the org chart? Like, how does that work? Like, are they thinking creatively about and intentionally about how that person's going to find success? And then my third reaction is, why isn't it just a straight up experience officer that looks at an entire ecosystem, which makes me question where they fall in the org chart? So, you know, I think that's interesting. I would still love to see how that model works for them compared to other models that we've studied and models that we are chomping at the bit to try. But you're the org chart person.
Yeah,
blowing them up and then putting them back together.
Yeah, I don't think they've released yet quite what and who he's reporting to. As you and I know, we have a very dear friend, Sean Slavinsky, who I hope to get to jump on here with us as well. And he did a video with me when I interviewed him, and we can share that video at some point and tell people where to find it. But he said, as the CEO, if experience is not in your top three priorities, then you're missing it. And I think that's really powerful for us to understand that, you, like you said, Michael, the chief innovation officer, I was one of those in an organization. People didn't know what to do with the, well, what's your job, right?
Right.
Now,
well, what are the expectations, right?
Well, and now seeing this influx. I get daily notifications on LinkedIn. Hey, you would be a top hire for this role. Chief Experience Officer, Chief Customer Officer, and people still are trying to figure out what that means in this whole space. Yeah. I think it's interesting. I think McDonald's, I honestly think McDonald's needs it, it's going to be exciting to see what happens there. So
and is it just theater, or is there some oomph behind it, and how does that work?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
What influence do they have? And why is it just focused on customer? Why did they choose to put the word customer in the name when they had the opportunity to look at experience overall?
Yeah. And you and I have talked about that it's more than just a customer, right? It's more than just
it's
the whole ecosystem, and that you have to look at the whole ecosystem. Or you just continue down the silos and the paths that we have unfortunately seen a lot of, right? And mm-hmm. organizations that we go in and work with, we get just kind of blown away some days at what's happening there. So,
and wish the person luck who's taking the job. Like, I hope there's success there. I don't certainly my questions are just questions of wonder of what they're doing and how it's going to work. But absolutely wish them luck, because they certainly do employ a lot of folks in the country and do impact a lot of people and a lot of small towns especially. So
Yeah,
good luck. Yeah. Good luck. And let's let them be some industry leaders with us. That would be fantastic.
Absolutely. Well, Michael, it's coming to that time. We said we wanted we've got some exciting announcements for next week.
Yeah.
We have a very dear friend of ours who will be joining us. And her name is Donna Porter. She did some work with us here at Mophie previously. And she's going to join us next week, so you don't want to miss it.
Yeah, and the topic is going to be focusing on leadership and culture, which, you know, awesome. As we're looking at ecosystems, that, you know, that is a great starting place, because if you don't have your leaders aligned, then, you know, you can't expect anyone else to get anything done. Right.
Yeah.
And so what do you need to do to be able, either you are a leader or you have influence over that. We might even talk about managing up a little bit. If you're a frontline person who is frustrated by leadership, of what you can do to make things happen in the experience world.
Absolutely. Well, Michael, I'm really excited. We have made it through our first Experience Friday Live.
Yep.
Not too many glitches. Had a good time. Shared about our experience ecosystem, the promise. Again, remember, next week on Wednesday is the kickoff to our podcast, The Combustion Chronicles with Colin Shaw, Memories, Fishing Nets, and the Importance of Behavioral Science. You want to go download that. As well as Michael just talked about, Donna Porter will be here talking with us about leadership and culture. You can connect with Mophie on Instagram at Mophie Social, at Facebook, on Twitter, even on LinkedIn, as well as myself. You can look it up as Man on Fire Social and Michael Harper. Reach out. We would love to connect with you. And we're really excited about being back here next week for Experience Friday Live. So, Michael, have a great rest of the day. And to everybody, yep. We're going to put on the out music, and we will see you later.
Have a great weekend.